So what does a big house fan, lots and lots of pipe, and 5 million gallons of water have to do in common? Those are just three ingredients that make up Pat's Peak's powerful snowmaking system. In fact, Pat's Peak possesses one of the most powerful snowmaking systems in all of New England, and is one of the first ski areas to achieve 100% of their terrain peak. Pat's Peak uses three different kinds of guns in their snowmaking process, the first of which is the air water gun. These small, mobile ground guns can be carried by hand to areas that are hard to reach and can also be used when the temperature is warm. The tower guns are a fixed gun, using a long aluminum neck where two hoses connect to the piping network and bring together a stream of high-pressure water and a stream of high-pressure air outside of the snow gun. The water is atomized by the airstream and is blasted into the atmosphere, using the energy of both the compressed air and pressurized water to propel it out of the gun. They can be turned on at 26 degrees, and with the right conditions, can make a pile of snow 18 feet high in just one night. The tower guns are more energy efficient than the air water guns, but they can only make snow when it is colder and the area is larger to operate in. A fan gun is basically a huge house fan that blows the water particles into the air and gives them enough lift to fall slowly to the ground and freeze on the way to make snow. These guns can also make snow at warmer temperatures. The colder it gets, the more water they use, and on a very cold night, these fan guns can make massive amounts of snow. A large electric motor drives a fan pushing an airstream in a large metal tube about 3 feet long and 2 feet in diameter. Small water particles are fed into the airstream by nozzles around the outlet rim of the tube. The airstream carries them out 50 to 150 feet on the run, which freeze into snow particles before they land. A disadvantage of these guns is that they are very fixed, meaning wherever they are, they stay. Water is the only ingredient in making snow. So where does all the water come from? It sounds impressive when a ski area can claim to cover 100% of its terrain with snowmaking. But far more relevant to skiers is the amount of snow a ski area can make at one time. This is the only true measure of how fast an area can open new terrain or refresh surfaces during the course of the season. Since water is the raw material from which snow is made, water supply is the most critical determinant in how much snow a ski area can make. Pat's Peak has worked with local and state agencies towards the perfect win-win scenario for both industry and environment. While protecting the natural ecosystem, they now have access to water, which will allow them to make snow at colder temperatures, which in turn means they run less during times of warmer weather. This means greater energy savings, which is good for both the company and the environment. Two mountain reservoirs add to their capacity to make snow during times of peak snowmaking conditions. It is a science that takes a lot of experience to master. Snowmakers go to work when everyone is going to bed, including the sun, and work in nature's hardest weather. They go out into the dark and the cold to make it snow. This is snowmaking at Pat's Peak.